You also mentioned another study that you just your one of your research, you kind of said in passing that 13 hours of at least 13 hours of fast was associated with a lower breast cancer recurrence.
Right.
So, do you mind talking about that study for a little
Yeah,
bit?
I'd be glad to. So, this was a study in about 2,500 breast cancer survivors, and they completed over about 7.5 years of follow-up. They completed many food records, right? So we collected all this information about what they ate. But then more recently, when this hypothesis came out, we went and dug up all their food records and said, well, how about if we don't care what you ate, but we just care about when you ate it. So we re-entered all the data as far as when they started to eat, when they stopped, how long their fasting interval was, how much they ate at night, and then reanalyzed that data. And that's where we found that it seemed, at least in this sample of women, that the cut point of 13 hours reduced their risk of breast cancer recurrence by about 40%. It also reduced the risk of mortality by about 20% or a little more than that, but that was not statistically significant. But it was just trending in the same direction. It's possible because we do believe it's, although my area of research is breast cancer, we actually believe this dietary pattern could have really positive effects on other diseases and conditions, including type 2 diabetes or liver, fatty liver, NAFLD. Also with acid reflux, don't, the first thing they tell you is try to sit up when you go to bed, don't eat a big meal. So that, which often leads to esophageal cancer. So we actually feel it can have a positive impact on many aspects of metabolism, not just cancer. It's just that we're very interested in teasing out its impact on cancer.
That's phenomenal, Ruth, those statistics that you just kind of just threw out there, like 40% reduction in breast cancer recurrence in women that were just simply fasting in the evening for 13 hours. I
Right.
mean, that is, it's not,
Regardless of what you eat
regardless of
and
what you
controlled
eat.
for whether you're overweight or not.
Wow.
Right.
Because it's really not that difficult to, I think it's much easier to, for people to make a modifiable change of just stopping what they're, stop eating after 7 p.m. versus eat all your vegetables, stop eating
Right.
your cake. I mean, people should do that, but I'm
Diet,
saying.
yes, I still think diet quality matters, but we've done some pilot studies with women adopting a longer nightly fasting interval. And those studies have been amazing in terms of how simple it was for women to do it. We actually had a little app that I used, and they would text us starting my fast, and then we'd text back saying, great, don't forget, don't eat again before 8 a.m. or 9 a.m. And so many participants said, I never understood percent energy from fat. It was always so confusing to me. It made me just feel stupid. I didn't even know how to do it, but I just got this. In 5 minutes, I got this. I could do it. And self-report ways, they reported often sleeping better. We did it with a group of Latino women, Latinas, in South Bay, and they were particularly positive about it. They said, in my family, if I tried to change up our entire way we eat, sometimes my family members weren't that positive about that. Where's our favorite foods? And she goes, but this, I could do it right away. It was really simple, and it didn't affect the family or our food ways. So it was very easy for me to do within our family without disrupting all of our family behaviors. They were very positive and often even reported, I felt so proud of myself. Okay, finally, I'm doing something. I feel better. Well, I'm going to start walking too. That kind of self-efficacy kind of spread to other health behaviors, which is our hope.
Yeah.